If you're looking for encouragement today, you found the home of contagious encouragement, Keep the Faith. I'm Donna Cruz.
And I'm Keith Stevens. It's been a tough time, and maybe you've been knocked down, and now you've picked yourself up. You have a plan, and you're ready to move on, but you just need the confidence to make it happen. The songs and stories on Keep the Faith this hour have been specifically chosen just for you.
Comfort and safety were actually paralyzing me, and I wasn't living the adventure of a lifetime. In a way, I was so busy trying to keep up my standard of living that I wasn't living at all.
Give me a heart of love, David, Lord, be my defense, so I can face my giants with confidence.
I'm not a superhero. We tend to hold ourselves to these ridiculous standards. Things that we would never say to our best friend, we say to ourselves, and that only sabotages our opportunity to use the gifts that God has given us.
Singing, oh God, keep me in the moment. Help me live with my eyes wide open. I don't want to miss what you have for me.
Yeah, I don't want to be at the end of my life saying, what if I would have done this? What if I would have gone all in? What if I would have followed the dangerous, you know, scary thing that I knew God was calling me to do?
He said, I've been where you've been before. Down every hallway's a slamming door. No way out, no one to come and save me. Wasting the life that the good Lord gave me.
I dug into my own personal story in a big way. It's all with that desire of, man, going all in.
Trust in someone bigger.
So how do you build the confidence you need to make your comeback happen? Find out next on Keep the Faith.
Raindrops rolling off my brim. Streetlights got the pavement glistening. Touchdown, I fall into your arms. Right where I belong, your everlasting arms. And where would I be without you? I'd be in my bag when I need to stay. I be chasing every breeze that blows my way. I be building my kingdom just to watch it fade away. It's true, that's me without you. Ooh, 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 ooh. That's me without you.
song and story on Keep the Faith, you can find contagious encouragement to make your comeback happen.
Sometimes on this journey, I get lost in my mistakes. What looks to me like weakness is a canvas for your strength. And my story isn't over, my story's just begun. And failure won't define me, 'cause that's what my Father does. Yeah, failure won't define me, 'cause that's what my Father does.
Listening to Keep the Faith.
I'm Keith Stevens. So glad you're listening. When even the experts don't have all the answers, how are you expected to? So if you need a boost of confidence today, Dwight Bain has some encouragement for you. He's an author, counselor, and a life coach.
If you are feeling that overwhelming sense of dread, that's not a sign of weakness. It's a sign of human. And so I would say to get back that sense of safety, because you can't feel confident if you don't have some degree of safety. Some of that is going to be physical. Wash your hands 20 times a day, the Center for Disease Control says, to be able to pay attention to face masks in certain situations, to wear gloves, to maintain physical distancing. Good. Those are all essential, but those are physical. Those are medical. The bigger thing I want you to pay attention to is to feel safe inside emotionally. And this is the advantage the believer has, because instead of embracing fear, no, to stop that and to remember that in ancient Israel, when they were leaving Egypt's land, they got manna for the day. God didn't say, let me give you a detailed 18-month plan of what to expect. Nope. Here's what will carry you through today. I get back my safety when I go deep in my faith. I get back safety when I take care of my physical body. It's going to take a lot of courage to move forward. That's where confidence comes from. It comes from doing. And when you can build routines, even if you're unemployed right now, build routines. Get up every day. Take a shower. Dress like you're going to work or to a job interview. Don't just sit and hide under the covers. That will cause you to feel weaker. Listen to the word emotion, but hyphenate it. E-motion. because emotion comes from a root word of motion. When I'm moving, whether it be something as simple as a walk and praying for my friends and family, to just get up and move will brighten your mood. And so to be able to know, how do I get confidence? I'm going to breathe deep. I'm going to be a good steward of the body that God has given me. And then I'm going to start moving, because if you get up and you move, you can now get some momentum going to be able to tackle the next task, whatever that may be.
I'm not a warrior. I'm too afraid to lose. I feel unqualified for what you're calling me to. Lord, with your strength, I got no excuse. Broken people are exactly who you use. So give me faith like Daniel in the lion's den. Give me hope like Moses in the wilderness. Give me a heart like David, Lord, be my defense. So I can face my giants with confidence. You took a shepherd boy and made him a king. So I'm gonna trust you and give you everything. I'll be a conqueror, 'cause you fight for me. Gonna stand up, step out when you call. Jesus, Jesus, I'm gonna sing and shout and shake the walls. Won't stop until I see them fall. Gonna stand up, step out when you call. Jesus, give me faith like Daniel in the lion's den. Give me hope like Moses in the wilderness. Give me a heart like David, Lord, be my defense, so I can face my giants with confidence. Yeah! Give me faith like Daniel in the lion's den. Give me hope like Moses in the wilderness. Give me a heart like David, Lord, be my defense, so I can face my giants. My giants with confidence.
Simply ask yourself one question. What is my next right thing? The truth is, when we have those big decisions to make, rarely is it time right now to make it. Usually we have a little bit of space and maybe we can do one next right thing. And sometimes the next right thing is go take a shower, go to bed, think about it tomorrow. But that question can begin to carry us long term into those big decisions one step at a time.
If there's a road I should walk, help me find it.
Is Keep the Faith.
A basketball player was struggling to make it in the NBA until one thing changed, and it wasn't physical. That story is next on Keep the Faith.
I woke up this morning, saw a world full of trouble. Now I thought, how do we ever get so far down, and how's it ever gonna turn around? So I turned my eyes to heaven. I thought, God, why don't you do something? Well, I just couldn't bear the thought of people living in poverty.
poverty, children sold into slavery. The thought disgusted me, so I shook my fist at heaven. I said, God, why don't you do something? He said, I did. Yeah. I created you. If not us, then who? Something. So tired of talking about how we are God's hands and feet, but it's easier to say than to be. Live like angels of apathy. We'll tell ourselves it's alright, somebody else will do something. Well, I don't know about you, but I'm sick and tired of life with no desire. Says, I'm gonna do something. If not us, then who? If not me and you, right now, it's time for us to do something. If not now, then
resources to help you find the confidence for your comeback are at KeepTheFaith.com.
Where two or more are gathered in His name, He is there.
You're listening to Keep the Faith.
I'm Donna Cruz. Having the skill to make something happen is great, but often it's not enough. You need confidence. David Nurse is an NBA life development coach with a book called Pivot and Go. He has seen how the mental side of things can help players and people like you reach the goals they've made for themselves.
His name's Sean Kilpatrick. It was a couple years ago or 4 years ago now when I was coaching with the Nets. And he was called up from the NBA D League, which is like the minor league system to the NBA. So he was on a 10-day contract, 10 days to prove himself. He'd had a few 10-day contracts and stints in the NBA and they didn't pan out. He didn't perform very well. Now, Sean, I knew, was a very, very talented player. And when he played college basketball at Cincinnati, he was one of the best in the country. So when he came on that bus when we were out in Los Angeles about to play the Lakers the next night, we sat down and he was like, Coach, I'll do anything to make this team. And I knew we couldn't change his skill set, but we could change his mindset and his view and his perspective on himself, his self-confidence. So we stayed up late into the hours in his hotel room and we went through old Cincinnati film when he was dominant, even back to his high school days at White Plains, New York, and he had a day named after him and the mayor gave him a key to the city. Like, he was that player. It's not who the NBA and the world had now been telling him was a failure, but we lived in that moment, in that time where who he truly was, the best version of himself. And we continued to watch that and watch that and watch that. And the next night we were sitting there in the locker room before the game. And I remember looking at him, I said, hey, Sean, where are we? And he looked back at me and said, we're at Staples Center. I was like, no, Sean, that's where the Lakers are at. Where are we? And it clicked. He got it. He's like, Coach, we're in White Plains. We're definitely in White Plains. Meaning he was going to live in that highlight reel zone of who he knew he was, not who everybody else was saying he was, just because he made that small mindset pivot. And he went out that night. We didn't win that game because we didn't win a whole lot of games that year as it was, but he changed the tempo, the energy, the atmosphere of the game. He got another 10-day contract. He got a contract extension to the end of the season, and then we got a 3-year deal after the season and became a starter that next year.
I keep fighting voices in my mind that say I'm not enough. Every single lie that tells me I will never measure up. Am I more than just the sum of every high and every low? Remind me once again just who I am, because I need to know. Ooh, oh, you say I'm loved when I can't feel a thing. You say I'm strong when I think I'm weak. And you say I'm hell when I am falling short. I don't belong. Oh, you say I am yours.
have things that we want to lock up in the good room, talents that we are too shy to share, joy that we postpone, time with our loved ones that we delay. But the truth is that none of us know how long we have. So don't keep your gifts locked up. Go ahead and open up the good room in your own heart. Seize the moment and share your time and talents. Let today be the special occasion you've been waiting for.
We know we were made for so much more than ordinary life. It's time for us to more than just survive. We were made to thrive.
This is Keep the Faith.
Next on Keep the Faith, it was a marathon, but it was a picture of so much more.
The people who are at this cheer station see them, and as they're standing there cheering, they see these two women, and one reaches out and holds the hand of the other.
The weapon may be formed, but it won't prosper. When the darkness falls, it won't prevail. Cause the God I serve knows only how to triumph. My God will never fail. Oh, my God will never fail. I'm gonna see a victory. I'm gonna see a victory. For the I'm
your comeback can begin with encouragement. Welcome to the home of contagious encouragement. Keep the faith.
Right now I'm staring down a giant. Right now I can't see past my pain. Right now my songs have turned to silence. And you've never seemed so far away. But I still believe. I still believe. There's no high you can't rescue. No war you can't win. No story so over it can't start again.
To keep the faith.
Hey, I'm Keith Stevens. It's been said that dreams are a team sport. So as you find the confidence to make your comeback happen, it's so helpful to have others who support you. Jennifer Rothschild is a best-selling author with books like Me, Myself, and Lies, and saw a powerful picture of this.
It was the Pittsburgh Marathon. Two of those runners were women who didn't know each other. One was named Laura. It was her 12th marathon. And the other woman was named Jessica, and it was her first marathon. So the gun sounds and all the runners take off. And so mile after mile, these women are running. Jessica didn't think she was going to make it to the end. She even talked about how she thought to herself, I cannot do this by myself. At mile 14, she meets Laura. And Laura, who's so experienced in running marathons, sees that Jessica is working as hard as she can, and she is just giving it 100%. And so Laura says to Jessica, I'm going to make you a promise. I'm not going to leave you if you don't leave me. And no matter what, we're going to cross the finish line together. And so they did. And as they kept running, they realized no one else was even around them. And the sweep car was right behind them, and they're exhausted. They're raw with emotion, but there's a cheer station at mile 25. And so the people who are at this cheer station see them. And as they're standing there cheering, they see these two women, one black, one white, and they both are unwilling to quit and unwilling to leave each other. And one reaches out and holds the hand of the other. And Laura and Jessica, they ran holding hands that remaining mile, and they were the last to finish. They were the last to cross the finish line, but they finished, and they finished the race together. And so after the race, Jessica said, "You know, it wasn't about gender, and it wasn't about race or religion. We are just two people who had a goal in mind, and we leaned on each other to get there."
This is for the busted hearts. This is for the question marks. This is for the outcast soul, lost control, no one knows. Sing it for the can't go back. Sing it for the broken past. Sing it for the just found out life is now upside down.
If you're looking for hope tonight, raise your hand.
One foot in front of the other, pick up that phone, get on that computer, everything gets better. If I were to be frozen in fear, I have no idea where my son would be today.
This is Keep the Faith.
Sarah Taylor with another encouraging thought here on Keep the Faith from Will Rogers. Even if you're on the right track, you'll get run over if you just sit there.
here to stand and watch. I could say a prayer and just move on, like nothing's wrong. But I refuse, 'cause I don't wanna live like I don't care. I don't wanna say another empty prayer. Oh, I refuse to sit around and wait for someone else to do what God has called me to do myself. Oh, I could choose not to move, but I
Confidence coach Trish Blackwell. You can make it happen. You can take that goal, that dream, that comeback, and make it a reality. It's possible that you've already experienced that, and we'd love to hear your story. Just call 800-726-4150. That's 800-726-4150.
When I first started finding Trish and my goal of getting tenure, I teach in a public school, teaching middle school students reading, and it was my year. This is my year to show off everything I know, right? So my observers, I need to be on it, and I need to master everything. And then COVID came, and we're working from home, and I didn't have any observations, and it turned out I was not offered that tenure opportunity. I've taken a few turns renewing my thoughts and my thinking process and what I say to myself throughout these last months and this year, especially around fear of failure. The most recent and probably the most impactful part of this community since I've joined has been the monthly challenge. Last month, it was an ask challenge. So ask for referrals, ask for business, ask for advice, ask for a recommendation. And that really pushed me both in my career and my summer job of just asking and knowing it's okay to get a no, because every no is one step closer to a yes. This monthly challenge is really keeping me on my toes and keeping me accountable for something that I may not be able to see right away, but I think in the future it'll pay off and it'll show up in ways that I didn't even expect at this time.
You can have a similar story to the one that Joan has. In fact, my masterclass called Fear Detox is available right now for free to the Keep the Faith family. Your comeback from fear begins at KeepTheFaith.com.
See what I see.